Hey, Kevin, what are you doing?
You know, when I got this mill, I knew that there'd be a lot to learn. There's a lot more versatility in this. There's a lot more attachments in this. There's a lot more tooling that goes with this that, sorry, I have to buy most of it. But just trying to figure out what your order of operation is, when to make this cut, when to make that cut, what tool to use, what feature to use, how you want to make it all work. Just mind-boggling what it all does. You know what a drill press is, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. Well, yeah. See, this is a chuck like you would have in a drill press. And you would normally take a drill and put a drill inside the chuck, and you would take the key and you would tighten up the chuck, and then the drill press would turn the chuck, and that's what makes the drill press work. Well, it's, you know, the mill is kind of like a huge drill press, but it does a zillion other things at the same time. See, I can take this chuck and I can put it up inside, and there's a little rod up top that helps me that allows this to pull up inside and sink in there, and then I can use it like a drill press, basically. And I can drill holes with it, I can use the chuck. But even a really good chuck, even a really expensive one, one that's quote-unquote precision, isn't quite as centered, quite as balanced, quite as perfect as a collet. You know what a collet is?
No.
Not collard greens, a collet. See, this is a collet. Metal shaft with a taper, with a precision hole inside, made on a mill more than likely, but with these little slits in it. When you fit this up inside the mill, gotta find the key, and then you tighten it down and you suck that collet up inside, what happens is these ends close up. So when you put your end mill up inside there, and then you put it up inside and you close it up, this grips the end mill. Not everything is perfectly aligned. There's no wobble, there's no run out, there's nothing out of shape. Now you're going to get a much better, much straighter, more precision cut. Assuming you turn the handle the right way, that's important. I said, so many things to learn. Well, let me get this up there and I'll get to work. That's all there is to it. You put it up inside. You get your adjustment right on there so it's sticking up as far as you need it, where you want it. Tighten up the quill shaft on the top. Make sure you take your wrench off. Don't leave your wrench up there, because this part turns when you turn the machine on. Now you're ready to go. You can run your table up, you can move it, you can do whatever you need. Put your work inside. Get to work. Oh yeah, that's my job. Get to work. I'll see you next time.